Hello, everybody. Welcome to Red Tool House. It is a rainy day, and we're going to take advantage of that by inspecting our homestead.
In 2000, we bought an abandoned 100-acre farm in the foothills of the Appalachian Mountains. We spent years cleaning it up, built a new house, and now are trying to make it a functional homestead farm. Welcome to Red Tool House.
So what am I inspecting on a day like today? Well, we've in the past 24 hours, we received several inches of rain. Last night, as I was sleeping, I was actually awoken to a torrent of rain pounding on the roof. And I thought, wow, that's going to raise the water quite a bit. And it rained and rained and rained. Rained for probably 4 hours straight that heavily. So I decided to come out today and just inspect some of the things that we've put in. You see how the streams are doing, see how some of the swales are doing, some of the little ponds that I've built, those type of things. Just see how they're doing with all this rain. You can see there's water coming right down the center of the road, right in my track. You know, a ditch should be over here. My ditches have filled in over time. I need to pull those. But one thing I did do, came back to this point earlier this year, actually when it was dry in August. In fact, I think my dad did this with a tractor. Had him take the tractor bucket and cut this in timbering. We call it a water bar. Just, you know, something that's going to keep the water from continuing to run down the road. Permaculture, maybe you call it a swale, a mini swale, a ditch, if you will. There's all kinds of ways you can call it. But had we not done this, the water would have continued on. And you really can't tell by the angle, sure, the relief. But then this hill goes down pretty steeply. And it was getting to the point where it's cutting a pretty deep trench in my road. So putting this swale here, this water bar, of course, the water comes down, hits this, and immediately takes a 90 degree over into an old watershed. And so it drains down, drops about 30 feet. And down there, I've built a small pond. It's tough to call it a pond. It's actually just a big hole of water that was about the size of my tractor bucket. Dug it down real deep. And this is our north pasture for the pigs. So the pigs get to obviously enjoy that that hole of water in the summertime when it's hot. They get to enjoy that, to lay in it, but also get to drink from it. And it's not, I don't have to worry about you know, them tearing it up too much, because it really is just a big puddle. But I'm really glad to see how this is handling. In fact, you can see this even fans out a little bit here, so I'm not getting a lot of erosion. You know, there's a little bit of silt building up in the swale. I can see a little bit of stone being exposed, so I know a little bit of topsoil is being removed as it goes over. So again, with this type of relief, that's something we always have to deal with in West Virginia, is a little bit of erosion. So higher up in elevation on my road is another little swale. I was just down there in that previous scene. So this is an opportunity to stop water even before it makes it that far. So these water bars, again, to manage a road on with any type of grade, you want to get water off of it as soon as possible. So I've got this small swale cut here, and I'm trying to get it to fan out, and it actually just goes into my small orchard that I've created. I've got my fruit trees here, my elderberries, comfrey, all those things. So this water fans out and goes through that spot. So that helps divert the water away and keeps from cutting my road out. And this is handling quite well. This is kind of an odd angle, but I wanted to try to fan out as much as possible before it goes on past the orchard. Now, what I should be doing next dry season is get in here with the orchard and actually cut some swales. So right now the water's just kind of passing through. It's not getting over to my trees to the far left. It's kind of just passing through and going on down into the pasture. So what I need to do is bank some dirt there to make some swales to slow that water down, to let it hang out here in the orchard for as long as possible. You know about our creek crossing. This is how we get to and from our property from the county road. The county road is this road going down the hill right there. And this is our driveway coming in through this massive water right now. And again, 95% of the time, this creek is just very low. You drive through it easily with a truck or a car. We have people out, no problem. Right now, on a day like today where we received all this rain, it's a bit of an issue. Now, I could safely get through here with a truck, no problem. Kelly's Volvo will be fine coming through here. Smaller sedan, probably not the key thing. It's kind of funny, we always joke with people, it's tough to get in, it's easy to get out, because when you get out, you're kind of heading downstream, so the water pushes you a little bit. Coming up, you go against this water. And people have wondered, people have asked, how come you don't build a bridge or don't put a culvert in or those type of things? Ideally, I'd love to have a bridge here. It'd be great to have. But it's one of those things, it hadn't made it up the priority list. B, there's a considerable expense. And C, I'm always afraid of, once I put a bridge in here and block the only way to get on the property, obviously a bridge isn't blocking it, but bridge obviously automatically has limitations. So I have to build it strong enough to handle a concrete truck. I'd have to build it strong enough to handle any of those type of materials being delivered. But even if I wanted to have a dozer brought in, I'd have to have a way to get the dozer across my creek, and my creek bank down here is pretty steep. So I'd actually have to cut a way to bring a dozer in, because you definitely wouldn't want to run a dozer across your bridge if you built one. So right now I can obviously just run it right through, it wouldn't be a problem. So that is a concern I have. And quite frankly, like I said, 95% of the time, it's a non-issue. I kind of like the nostalgia. People look at me funny when I say, to get to my place, you got to drive through a creek. They're like, oh my goodness, where do you live? Are you that far out in the sticks? Yeah, we are, but we like it. So right now, the water is decently, I've seen it a lot higher. In fact, I'll roll a video clip now of a couple years ago with Kelly. I was already on the homestead. I was on the property, and Kelly and the boys were away, and they came in and they brought Kelly's Pathfinder, Nissan Pathfinder, through the creek. It was a little bit higher than I like. I wasn't too comfortable with it, but I had no way to get on the other side of the creek to drive it over for her. But she did a great job, and so I didn't have to record their demise crossing the creek. But so there's times it's an issue. But again, today I get to inspect to see how. You can see this stream coming down through here. This is actually my road. Again, no ditch here. Ideally, I should have a ditch. I should have this culvert, a pipe of some sort to take this water that's coming all the way down the driveway, coming all the way down from the wood shop and the barn. It's coming right down through here, so it washes out some of my gravel. In fact, if I waited and filmed this tomorrow, then there'd be a pretty good sandbar right in the dead center of that. So that's where I have to take my tractor and smooth all that out and drag it back up here. So it's a lot of recycling of gravel and sand and all those things. So here's a perfect reason as to why to go around and inspect and investigate what the water's doing. This little waterfall here, what I consider one of the most aesthetically pleasing areas of the property when we've had a lot of rain. You got the nice water coming down the stone. It looks really nice. Well, this is the edge of the pig pasture as well. And I have some hungry pigs. I haven't fed them yet, so that's why they're hanging out. This water's coming down. It should come right into this ditch and go on down the side of the meadow and dump into the creek way down. But I can see here, because of some of the activity the pigs have done, they've actually pushed this piece of wood in a way, this log, and it's actually dammed up this ditch a bit, and it's going right down into my pig pasture. And I was wondering, I could see it from the house. I'm like, well, why is there such a large puddle of water there? So ideally, I need to get in here and clean this out. If I didn't have all my camera equipment with me, I would simply just dig it out here, but see if I can make a little opening with my boot under this log for now, and I can come down and resolve that later. Even. Yeah, here we go. So usually what happens when I move something in the pig pasture, then the pigs come back and move it back for me, as if they meant to put that there. So again, just a good example of why to check this stuff out. You can prevent some erosion from going on, get things going back the direction they should be, and keep from having a muddy mess over in a spot where all your pigs are. See, the more mud you have, the more of an issue you get with pigs. Thank you. earlier about the winter solstice, figuring out where the sun is in its lowest time of the year and how that affects sunlight on your property. But in this situation, a day like today where we've had an excessive amount of rain, this is, you know, atypical of what we get, not crazy flood, but this has been a couple inches in 24 hours. I can go around and look on the homestead to see, okay, how are these small streams that are normally dry throughout the year, how are they handling this water? And I'm standing right here at our marriage retreat spot, and actually where the camera is our clearing where I would, you know, like to start building structures or at least have a campfire setting area. Well, we've got this small watershed that comes right down into this area. So you can see it's coming down and it's actually just turning and just fanning out throughout. So that whole bottom there, that whole meadow, is just full of water. So this gives me a good idea. Okay, it's naturally coming this way. I could maybe come down and cut a ditch and get it further downstream, or I could put a pipe in to go over to the main creek. There's all kinds of things I can look at to see, but also know the amount of water volume that we received in the last 24 hours, just how much water to expect coming off of this hill. And I can even go up to this next bench and cut a swale or redirect to put the water going that direction, because this is the lowest part of the valley. There's actually four benches above there, so this is actually, you know, all the way from the mountaintop down. So I can point that in a different direction before it even gets here. Opportunity to check on my creek crossings with my electric fence. So if you go back quite a few episodes, I've got to bust my butt here in the process of standing in this water. Rocks are slick. You can see the electric fence here. Woo! There's a hole in the boot there somewhere. I've only got one little wire that's hanging down in the water right now. Everybody else is hanging just above the water line. So again, I know my pigs aren't going to try to come through here in this swift water. They won't mess with it. I definitely got a hole in my boot somewhere, filling full of water. So there's, that's pretty good tell that this is going to hold true and not be an issue. Obviously, even if the water would get a little higher, it's just going to push those wires down. You see the one that's in the water is just rocking back and forth a little bit. Obviously, that's shorting out the fence, but my pigs right now in this weather, they're not going anywhere. They're going to hang out. It's not like they're testing the fence constantly. So even if there's some debris or anything coming down, if a big log would come down here, it's just going to hit those little hanging pins and just knock back there. So if you're curious to see what I'm talking about, just check out the video up here. I'll put a link in it there so you can see where we built this creek crossing. Really helped keep the pigs from coming through. It didn't get ripped down all the time like the old crossbars that I had. Well, so it looks like everything is where it's supposed to be. It seemed to handle the water fine. A couple little issues with things just silting in. Now, obviously, I didn't go on the far back of the property. Still have some roads I've got to get repaired back there. Got some slips. We'll cover that in some other videos. But I just encourage you, if you have a weather event, like a heavy rain, snow, whatever, take that time to go out while the water's up, while the snow's on, all those type of things, and check out what's going on in your homestead. Again, check your gutter drains, check areas around your buildings, check your chicken coop, make sure your chickens aren't standing in a bunch of water. Check to see how your streams, puddles, all those things are handling the excessive water or the excessive snow right now. Well, we appreciate everybody watching. Be sure to check us out next time. Take care.